Hello everyone. In this video lecture, we will be talking about adjustments in final accounts. Certain transactions belonging to current accounting period, which at the time of preparation of trial balance may not be recorded, and some transactions not belonging to current accounting year might have been recorded in the books. These transactions need to be adjusted in the books of accounts in order to ascertain correct performance and financial position. Such transactions are called adjustments. Adjustments are given as an additional information outside the trial balance as footnotes. So, every adjustment given outside the trial balance will be recorded at two places, that is, in trading account or P&L account and in balance sheet. Now, let's move on to the objectives of adjustments. The basic objective is to present true profit or loss on accrual basis and to portray true and fair financial position of the business. To take account of the expenses of current year yet not entered in the books of account. To take account of the incomes of current year not yet recorded in the books of accounts. To consider non-cash income and expenses, for example, interest on capital, drawings, depreciation on fixed assets, etc. Now, let's have a look at some important adjustments. Some of the important adjustments are closing stock, accruals, advances, depreciation, bad debts, and provisions. Let's talk about closing stock first. If closing stock is given in trial balance only, then it will be shown as an asset in the balance sheet. And if it is given in adjustment, it will be shown as an asset in the balance sheet and on the credit side of trading account. Moving on to accruals. Now, accruals have been classified into two categories, that is, accrual income and accrual expenses. Now, if accrual income is given in trial balance only, then it will be shown on asset side of balance sheet. And if it is shown in adjustment, it will be shown on asset side of balance sheet and added in respective income in income statement as well. Now, moving on to accrual expenses, if it is only shown in trial balance, it will be shown on liability side of balance sheet. And if accrual expenses are given in adjustments, it will be shown in liability side of balance sheet and added in respective expense in income statement. Now, let's talk about advances. Advance income, if it is shown in trial balance only, it is our liability. And if advance income is shown in adjustments, it is liability as well as it is subtracted from respective income in income statement. And in case of advance expenses, if it is given in trial balance, it will be shown on asset side of balance sheet. And in case it is shown in adjustment, it will be shown on asset side of balance sheet as well as it will be subtracted from respective expense in income statement. Now let's move to depreciation. If depreciation is given in trial balance, it is shown as an expense in P&L account. And if it is given in adjustment, it is shown as an expense in P&L account and subtracted from the respective asset in the balance sheet. Now let's talk about bad debts and provisions. If bad debts are given in trial balance, they are shown as expense in profit and loss account. If it is given in adjustment, it is shown as expense in P&L account and deducted from debtors in the balance sheet. Next one is provisions for bad and doubtful debts. If it is given in trial balance, it is shown as liability in the balance sheet or deducted from debtors on asset side. And if it is given in adjustment, it is debited to P&L account with additional amount required after considering provision already made, and shown as liability in the balance sheet or deduction from debtors on asset side. Now let's have a look at a numerical example with adjustments. As we can see from the example, various details have been given in the question. Along with the detail given in the box, there is additional information, that is adjustments. Now let's move to the solution. We'll start the solution with writing trading and P&L account for the year ended 31st March 2014. As we know, it is a T-shaped account, so left side will be debit side and right side will be credit side. We'll start with trading account, that is with opening stock. So we will write opening stock $11,460. And again, on the debit side, we'll write purchases, that is $80,000, less purchase returns, that is $2,820. So net purchases comes to be $77,180. Next one is carriage inwards. Carriage inwards is given as $2,310 and wages as $6,280. And moving to the credit side of trading account, we will write sales as $1,40,370 less sales returns $4,240. So net sales comes to be $1,36,130. And closing stock is given as $14,290. So at the end, we will tally both the sides and we will find that debit side is falling short by $53,190, that is our gross profit. And now, gross profit will be brought forward on the right side, that is credit side of P&L account. Moving to the expenses side, that is debit side of P&L account, we will write railway freight on sales, that is $16,940, office expenses $1,340, postage and telegram $820, printing and stationery $660, and salary and commission $9,870, along with outstanding salary, that is $570. So total comes to be $10,440. Moving on to the next expense, that is rates and insurance, which is $1,300. We will subtract unexpired insurance, which is $240. Now, unexpired insurance is given on 7th point of the question, adjustments. Next one is bad debts. Bad debts are $1,400 and we are supposed to add further bad debts of $570. Furthermore, we are supposed to add new doubtful debts, that is $3,690. At the end, we get $5,660. And we are supposed to subtract old provision for bad debts as $3,240. So the total comes to be $2,420. Moving on to the next expense, that is interest on capital, $5,000. Depreciation on building, $625. Depreciation on addition to building, $140. Depreciation on furniture, $175. Moving on to the credit side of P&L account, we will write rent received, $2,100. And we will add accrued income, that is accrued rent, $200. It will be $2,300 as rent. And last, that is discount received, which is $190. After telling both the sides, we will find, again, debit side is falling short by $16,060, that is our net profit. Now, this net profit is supposed to be transferred to capital account. Now, let's start with the balance sheet. We will write balance sheet as at 31st March 2014. Again, it is a T-shape account and we are supposed to write liabilities on left side and assets on right side. Starting with the asset side, that is cash at bank, $12,400. Cash in hand, $2,210. Bills receivables, $1,240, that is $1,240. And debtors will be $62,070 less further bad debts, that is $570, less new provision, $3,690, which comes to be $57,810. So we will write debtors as $57,810. Accrued rent, $200. Unexpired insurance, $240. Building, $25,000. Less depreciation, that is $625. So the total of buildings will be $24,375. Addition to building is $7,000 and less depreciation is $140. So total is $6,860. Moving on to the next asset, that is office furniture, which is $3,500, less depreciation, $175, which comes to be $3,325. And the last item is closing stock, which is to be posted on asset sides again, which is $14,290. And the total of asset side comes to be $1,22,950. And moving to the liabilities side, that is sundry creditors, $18,920, outstanding salaries, $570, capital, $1,00,000, and net profit is supposed to be added, that is $16,060. If in case it would have been net loss, we were supposed to write $16,060 in negative. But in this question, it is net profit, so we will be adding it. Again, we are supposed to add interest on capital, that is $5,000. And at last, we are supposed to subtract drawings, that is $17,600. So at the end, we get the total of capital as $1,03,460. Again, the total of liabilities comes to be $1,22,950. So in order to check the answer, what we can do is we are supposed to tally the balance on both sides, that is liabilities and asset sides as well. And in this answer, the balance on both sides is $1,22,950. It means the balance has tallied. So the answer is correct. Thank you.